Okay, so I won't be very long. I just want to say thanks to, first of all, thanks to you, to all of you for participating today. I think it ended up being a very successful afternoon. Now I feel good. It was a very good idea to decide to do this a few months ago when we did as a chamber council. Special thanks to the Honorable Roy MacTaggart. I know he's not here now. To Cayman Finance, to CETA, and to Suriba, and all the industry leaders and experts who participated in the panel or made presentations today. The next step for us as a Chamber of Commerce is that we will develop a summary of the discussions today, and we're going to make that public. We really just wanted to start a discussion about where our economy is, what the challenges are, what the opportunities are, where we can improve. We have a lot more, I'll say, more in-depth initiatives that focus on this area. For example, we have industry roundtables coming up. We're meeting with the restaurants soon. We're going to be talking to Cayman Finance as well, because we're also going to have a roundtable on financial services issues, where we sit in smaller groups and talk about the challenges and where we need to go, and the opportunities as well, all the positive stuff as well. But to be more strategic about the economy, and we have to start with the various industries. We, as I said at the very beginning, the Chamber, we see ourselves as an umbrella organization that represents all commerce in the country. That's what I'll always be speaking about, everything from carpenters to investment funds, attorneys to bankers to plumbers. It's all the same thing to us. It's all about commerce. It's all about having an engine to drive the economy. It's all about employing persons. It's all about government revenue to support the rest of the country, and that's what we call commerce. We will work directly then with the industry-specific associations on the different issues. They can bring their expertise to the table. They can inform us on specific things. And we'll use our mechanisms, our chamber clout, which is, there is some serious clout. Our advocacy link, yes, it's a very strong advocacy link. And we'll use that to help everyone, the industry bodies. We can help you. We can certainly help you. Our members, of course, we're helping you every day, and that's what we're here for. So I just want to say thanks again for coming. Special thanks to JN Money Services and BDO as sponsors of the event. I hope you really enjoyed it. The drinks are on me afterwards. They're not really on me. They're sponsored by Cayman First, thankfully. But I hope you stay with us at least for that time. And I want to say one last thing. I don't know the name of the very well-spoken Irish lady, but I think what you had to say was very important, because you spoke about unity. You spoke about alpha males, which apparently I just managed. I didn't even realize I was managing alpha males. But I think what you spoke about in terms of unity and what you spoke about in terms of equity is very important in an economic discussion, because the economic discussion isn't about how fast we can grow all the time, right? It's also about who benefits from the growth. This is equity. And the fact that you would mention those other professions and how they feel and how they're treated is very important, because you cannot have a successful environment. As we always say in the Chamber, you cannot have a successful business in a community that isn't successful, right? It's impossible. That those equations don't work. And for the same reason, you cannot have a successful economic strategy if you're not simultaneously and very intensely, actually, concerned about things like equity, equality, and fairness and treatment of people as well. So I want you to give an applause to the lady for coming. And I thought that just brought everything together very nicely for me. And just thanks again, and hope to see you again soon. Thank you.